Hello, in this video I come up with the topic ECI. So ECI stands for Election Commission of India. So this is an authority, this is the highest body that holds elections in India. It looks after all the election process in the country. So we can say this is the administrator of elections in India. So for the elections of which offices we see are listed here. So as we can see, it is for the elections of Lok Sabha, members of Rajya Sabha, and in the states for state legislative assembly, state legislative councils, and it also holds elections for the offices of president and vice president of India. So this holds the whole definition of ECI basically, and this is formed in the year 1950 on January 25th. So this is the formation day of ECI, which is celebrated as National Voters Day. So on this day we celebrate this particular day of National Voters Day every year in order to bring awareness amongst voters how well they must utilize their voting right. And it is headquartered at New Delhi, and in the same place we have this ECI secretariat working, and we'll see some few points about how this ECI got its authority. And it is an autonomous body, that means it has got its freedom of working, and it is a constitutional body, so it takes its constitutional backing with some articles. They are from Article 324 to Article 329. So these articles in Indian Constitution gives authority to ECI to work to conduct elections in India. And this has got its got an act which gives its enactment, that is Representation of People's Act. So as we are electing representatives of us and representatives of people, this has got its enactment out of this Act of Representation of People's Act. So these are some backings for its working, and now we'll see its what constitutes Election Commission of India, who are the members and all. And to hold elections in states, we have three authorities, that are Chief Electoral Officer, so he is the chief who conducts elections in the state under ECI, and we have District Magistrates who monitors in the elections in districts under ECI they work. And we also have election registration officers also working to hold elections in states. And in the national level, we have this heading, the main heads of ECI in 1+2 setup. So one chief election commissioner, who is presently Sunil Arora, and two election commissioners of India. One is Rajiv Kumar and one is Sushil Chandra. So we have this 1+2 setup presently. And apart from these main heads of ECI, we also have deputy election commissioners, director generals, and principal secretaries, secretaries, and under secretaries also working for holding elections. So who assist these 1+2 election commissioners of India? And we'll see some acts and rules under which these election commissioners have come up. So we started having these two additional election commissioners apart from chief election commissioner from 1989. So the first time these two posts are created was on October 16, 1989. So this came with an act called Election Commissioners Amendment Act 1989. So in this act, we added these two extra posts to Chief Election Commissioner of India. But this got adopted on January 1st, 1990. So since then we got this adopted, this act got adopted, and Election Commissioners Condition of Service Rules 1992. We have these rules that speak about the position of these election commissioners of India, this 1+2 setup. So their salaries or allowances are similar to, or their cadre is similar to, judges of Supreme Court. So this is what this rules of Election Commissioners Condition of Service Rules 1992 say. So they have this cadre, service, allowances similar to judges of Supreme Court. Now we'll see the roles and functions of Election Commission of India. We know it conducts elections. So elections are very important for a democratic country because they put up the whole true spirit of democracy, that people will elect their own representatives, people are the rulers. So holding elections or conducting elections is a very important thing in India. So Election Commission of India is with the same significance. So the next thing is it decides election schedules. So it must schedule the elections for the general elections or for any by-elections. This has to give out its schedule where, when to conduct. And it prepares the electoral roll. So this duty is also by ECI, wherein electoral roll is prepared by it, in which it has got all the listing of the voters who all can vote. So who all got that identity of voting, they all are listed under what districts they can vote, under what constituencies they come. That is its preparation of electoral roll. So this is a huge task taken up by ECI during elections, and it issues EPIC, electors photo identity card. So EPIC, we started giving these EPICs to voters from the year 1993 in order to avoid frauds. So one voter can vote only once. So for that reason, to bring transparency, these photo ID cards were issued from 1993, but later it got mandatory from the year 2004. So since 2004, EPIC has become a mandate for any voter to cast their vote. So later again, we have other function, like it locates polling stations and counting centers. So for casting the votes, for electing the representatives, there has to be a setup and infrastructure. So for that, where the pollings have to be conducted. So it locates those stations, it gives security, and it brings out all this machinery needed there. So it locates them, and also the counting centers it organizes where to count the votes polled. So these are basically the basic things, and it also has got some major things on part of political parties. That is, if a political party needs recognition for contesting an elections, ECI must approve that. So if there is a political party and if it is supposed to contest in an election, that recognition must be granted by ECI. And it allots symbols to political parties. As we know, each political party will have its own unique symbol. So that symbol allotment is also done by Election Commission of India. And it advises post-election disqualifying. So it has got the advisory jurisdiction of post-election disqualifying. If a member is elected, but if there is any legal strong backing that he must be disqualified, that he has followed some fraud things or whatever, this ECI has got advisory role in telling to disqualify this particular member. So this advisory jurisdiction it holds, and it issues model code of conduct. So model code of conduct is issued for candidates and political parties. So during that particular period of election and prior to the election. So in this time, they are not supposed to indulge in any frauds, in any wrong things, in any extra things than mandated by ECI. So this issue of model code of conduct for candidates is also done by ECI, and it sets limits for campaign expenditure. So political parties does campaign. They go for campaigning in order to bring their picturing in front of the public. So for this campaigning, they need to spend. So this expenditure must not exceed a limit. So ECI also checks to this end. And it organizes EVMs and VVPATs, electronic voting machines, or the machines in which we actually cast the vote. So EVMs have come up in India in 1990s only. So in 1998 and in between 2001, we started using this in phased manner all over India. And VVPATs are very latest that have come in the year 2012-13 around. So these are also brought in phased manner. And in 2014, they started working to the full end in the country. So this is a great achievement on part of Election Commission of India. So VVPATs are voter verifiable paper audit trials. What they basically do is they verify EVMs. So to check the transparency, they verify EVMs. We also have a Supreme Court judgment in April 2019 that these VVPATs must verify 2% of EVMs. So they are only supposed to verify 2% of EVMs, that is 5 polling booths in a constituency. So this is a recent Supreme Court judgment that is related to VVPATs and election process in India. So this is the whole broad picture of Election Commission of India, and thank you.